James R. Hogg was born on November 23, 1934 in Annapolis, Maryland, to James and Mary Jane Hogg. He was raised with his sisters Margaret and Marilee and brother Dave. His father commanded a destroyer in the Pacific during World War II. At the age of 10, this inspired Jim's unwavering desire to join the Navy and one day command a destroyer. His dad graduated from the Naval Academy class of 1927, so Jim knew the Academy was where he needed to go to achieve his goal. At the Academy, Jim played varsity squash for 3 years and was the 2nd Regiment Deputy Commander in the first set. The Lucky Bag noted his outstanding ability to render a sincere suggestion to any problem and meet the trials of a MID with a fresh and energetic approach. After graduation, Jim embarked on a 35-year Navy career in surface warfare with 9 tours at sea, 5 in command and 3 in the Vietnam War zone. He achieved his childhood dream when he assumed command of the guided missile frigate USS England. His ship and crew intercepted numerous North Vietnamese supply vessels and assisted in the rescue of downed pilots. He simultaneously commanded Destroyer Squadron 31 for 4 months. He then served as the executive assistant to the Chief of Naval Personnel for 3 years prior to his selection as the commander of Destroyer Squadron 7 in the Pacific. For his first flag assignment, he served as Director of Navy Personnel Policy, where he was the architect of the Navy's pay, benefits, and retention revival in 1979 through 1982. This was the largest improvement in pay, benefits, and quality of life issues in over 3 decades. His next assignment was Commander of Cruiser Destroyer Group 1. After 6 months, the group deployed and he served as Commander of Task Force 75. 3 months later, during tense Cold War operations, he was assigned as Commander 7th Fleet, the giant armada guarding the vast Western Pacific against Soviet incursions. His responsibilities included strengthening operational relations with the 21 friendly nations of the Pacific Rim. His leadership was highly praised and rewarded by Korea and Japan. Jim's final active duty assignment was as the U.S. representative to the NATO Military Committee. This occurred during significant changes in Europe and the world. The Warsaw Pact had collapsed, which brought an end to the Cold War. Jim retired from the Navy as an admiral in 1991. After 4 years as president of the National Security Industrial Association, Jim returned to the Navy as the civilian director of the Chief of Naval Operations Strategic Studies Group, where he continued to serve for 18 years. He was instrumental in transforming studies of maritime strategy to a research center that generated revolutionary warfighting concepts for the Navy's future. These concepts are a key focus in current naval strategies. They include the all-electric ship, electromagnetic railgun, electromagnetic maneuver warfare, directed energy weapons, unmanned systems, and cyber warfare. Jim also worked closely with over 700 officers and scientists in their professional and personal development. In honor of his achievements, several facilities have been named after him, including the Future Forces Gallery of the Naval War College and the firing line at the Navy's Railgun Development Center at Dahlgren, Virginia. In addition, IEEE has awarded him the Dr. Harry Fair Medal for outstanding contribution to railgun development. Jim appreciates the Naval Academy's positive impact on his life. He has served on boards and committees supporting academic, athletics, scholarships, and cyber warfare, was a trustee at large for the Naval Academy Alumni Association, has directly addressed the Brigade of Midshipmen, and has been a foundation trustee since 1993. He has also served as the chairman of the board for the Surface Navy Association since 1994, when he relieved Admiral Arleigh Burke. Jim and his wife, Ann, reside in Portsmouth, Rhode Island. They have 4 children and 4 grandchildren. Jim has a deep love for the sea and says his service in the Navy has been more meaningful to him than any other pursuit could possibly offer. He adds that his most significant work was the overhaul of pay and benefits in the early 80s. Operationally, command of the 7th Fleet at the peak of the Cold War was his most meaningful assignment. Admiral James R. Hogg, an innovative leader with a lifelong devotion to the Navy and our country.